So what's going on, guys? It is Jamie, it's V-Boxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click onto any of the videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of the videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, former IBF welterweight champion Sean Porter will be facing former 140-pound title challenger Thomas Delorme on the Mayweather Conor McGregor undercard on August 26th. And my reaction to this fight is, why? Why is Sean Porter fighting Thomas Delorme? Thomas Delorme, in my opinion, is somebody who's ready-made for Sean Porter, ready-made for his style, because Thomas Delorme is a fighter who doesn't like pressure. And Sean Porter is going to give him pressure, because that's the kind of fighter Sean Porter is. He likes to get up on the inside and maul his opponents. And don't get me wrong, Sean Porter is a decent fighter on the outside. He throws a good jab and he kind of like moves into the pressure, but eventually he does stick the pressure on his opponents, and that's what tends to wear him down. And I can see that happening to Thomas Delorme. So I don't really understand why this fight is happening. Like, I don't understand why Thomas Delorme would fight Porter, a guy whose style is all wrong for him. But at the end of the day, Thomas Delorme must be getting paid a bit of money for this fight. It is on the Conor McGregor Floyd Mayweather undercard, so he will be well paid, I'm guessing. But I'm a bit disappointed that this is the opponent Sean Porter is fighting, because a lot of people expected him to face Danny Garcia later on in the year for the interim WBC welterweight title, especially when he called Danny Garcia out in that odd video, and the WBC were pushing for that title fight because Keith Thurman, who is the WBC welterweight champion, can't fight till early 2018 because he's recovering from an elbow injury. But I'm thinking Danny Garcia doesn't want this fight, because Sean Porter called out Danny Garcia. He says he was going to take that fight. And Sean Porter looks to me like the kind of fighter who wouldn't duck that situation. And Danny Garcia has done it in the past. He has ducked a few opponents in the welterweight division. And apparently Danny Garcia might be fighting Luis Collazo. That's what I'm hearing through the grapevine. Garcia might be fighting Luis Collazo. Like, what the fuck? Like, Luis Collazo, yeah, he's coming off a good win over Sammy Vazquez. But Sammy Vazquez was never really a tested contender anyway in the welterweight division. And Luis Collazo is ancient. This guy has lost to Keith Thurman, Amir Khan. He lost to Ricky Hatton about 10 years ago. Like, Luis Collazo, he's just a gatekeeper in the welterweight division. So I don't understand why Danny Garcia would fight him. But at the same time, I don't understand why Sean Porter will fight Thomas Delorme when the two could fight each other. But obviously, boxing politics, shit happens. And this is another situation in which we're going to have to see a fight. In my opinion, that's not going to be very competitive, because I just don't see Thomas Delorme really doing anything to affect Sean Porter in there. Yeah, he does have a height and reach advantage over Porter, but once Porter gets on the inside against Thomas Delorme, I don't really see that being a massive factor, because Sean Porter's just going to be up on him, throwing them shots that he throws to wear guys down. So Thomas Delorme won't have the space to use his height and reach advantage. So, yeah, it's very interesting why the Garcia Porter fight didn't happen. And I'm a bit disappointed that Sean Porter will be fighting Thomas Delorme. And I'll be definitely disappointed if Danny Garcia fights Luis Collazo. Like, that's a shit fight. Like, who wants to see Danny Garcia and Luis Collazo at this point in Luis Collazo's career? Especially when guys like Amir Khan and Keith Thurman have already dealt with him. So, yeah, I don't really understand that. But, yeah, Sean Porter, Thomas Delorme on the undercard of Mayweather and Conor McGregor. What do you guys think of this fight? You guys might think it's a good fight. I'm just stating my opinion. But the general reaction I've got online, not a lot of people are impressed by this fight. So, it is what it is. It's JM. It is Speedboxing.